My first job was working as a consumer advocate in California, and I handled a great many nursing home violations and health violations and doctors who weren't licensed, or doctors who pretended to be doctors, and nurses who who packaged, for example, Mount St. Helena's volcanic ash as cancer cures and sold them on the market. That was my job, to track those people down. It was very interesting work. I loved it. Unfortunately, the field of consumer protection suffered a bit of a setback and has shriveled up in recent years, and that's when I went into teaching, because I thought I could be more of an advocate for those interests by writing. I've been writing ever since, in academia, as a journalist for The Nation magazine, principally. And this has been a really satisfying way to participate, not just in terms of legal advocacy, but also in terms of cultural conversations. I think that I would suggest to people in law school who want to pursue the kind of course I did, that mine was quite unorthodox. Not many people end up in teaching by taking the turn that I did. I, for example, did not go the usual clerkship routes, and people who want to teach often are advised to do clerkships. I did public interest law. I never worked for a large firm. But I always knew I wanted to write, and writing is actually what legitimized me for purposes of legal academia. Writing is what has allowed me to do journalism, even beyond the question of legal issues. Writing is what I've always loved. Writing is what I never gave up doing. And having something that you love, as cliched as that sounds, actually does allow you, over the course of a lifetime, to remain enthusiastic, give you the energy, and ultimately, I think, to be recognized and therefore have permission to do it as a career. My favorite author, I think, is Philip Pullman. I love Philip Pullman. I discovered him when my son was reading Philip Pullman. He's I guess technically a children's book author, but he wrote a trilogy called his Dark Materials, and it's a sort of wonderful philosophical science fiction adventure with all kinds of very a little bit dark, I think, but extraordinarily almost theologically inspired insights about the state of human nature and the politics of the day. I love Philip Pullman, and he's also just a lovely writer. I would also bring some Carl Hiaasen if I were actually on a trip, because Carl Hiaasen makes time pass. I need Carl Hiaasen for long airline rides, because he makes me laugh out loud. And I think on a political level, I'm always rereading, right now I think I'm rereading Jacopo Timmermans' Prisoner Without a Name, Cell Without a Number, because I'm considering the impact and import of things like Guantanamo Bay and Jacopo Timmermans' reflections on his imprisonment in prison during the time of the Argentinian junta has extraordinary and unfortunate contemporary resonance.